Hi guys, I'm back. So, well, today is just another tutorial. Well, first I'm gonna start off with this base, the Nivea Men Sensitive Foot Chiffon. Okay, just get a small amount to your hand. I'm gonna start off with this Marc and Jacobs foundation. This is in number 10. I really like. Can you see? So I'm just gonna grab some of the products and put it on my hand. My foundation brush. Okay. So I'm going to try this new brush. This is a local brand from Indonesia. It's called Tamiya. Well, let's see if it works well. First, I'm going to just blend it with my hands. And then even in out with this brush. Well, I guess it's not as good as my old foundation brush. This is my favorite that I got from Raw Color. It's supposed to be for powder foundation, but I find it really nice to apply liquid foundation as well. Next, we move on to cream contour palette. So I'm gonna highlight and contour my face, and I'm gonna use this another local brand called Pupa. So it comes in the 6 different colors and a little bit of directions on how to use them. I like to use my hand right now, so I'm just gonna grab this the pinkish one for my under eye. If you can see, I got that dark circle. You want orange tone to cover your dark circle. And then let's take the light one. Cover it. Maybe an inverted triangle shape. Normally it doesn't have to be very tiny. You're gonna even up over. I find this product is pretty good actually for a local brand. The price is like drugstore brand, so I'm gonna grab the yellowish color to cover my redness around the nose and under my chin, because this is actually the sensitive part of my face. The nose and the chin, where I get acne most of the time, pimples, and then they'll just leave scars. And this for the highlight. Well, now I look like a clown. Okay, next I'm gonna take this little brush. This comes from the old brush set. Okay, and then just grab the dark medium color, medium brown color, to draw on my nose. Contouring the nose is like one of the hardest parts for me, because my nose is a little rounded and short. Take the darker one, darkest color. A little bit here to give you an illusion of like what's blotching. I think it's nice, but you don't have to. Actually, okay, I'm just gonna use my finger for this one. Make a palm. A little bit extra over here because I've got squirrel's jaw. Okay, now it's blending time. I'm gonna get my apple brush for my highlight, so I'm gonna use this size. As you can see, it's blending pretty well actually. For staying power, it's pretty good too. I have very oily face and could stay for hours. Don't worry about that, we will blend it again later. I'm gonna take this brush to blend the rest of the contour on my face. And then we're gonna blend the highlight again, just to make sure that everything is blended well. I'm gonna take another small brush. This is the flat edge. The other one that I use for the contouring has a rounder edge. Just gonna use it to blend the highlight on my nose. Next, we move on to eyebrow brush, I guess. There's really no specific steps for me, so I'm just like, I'll do whatever I want. I guess there's really no rules for makeup, right? Today I'm just gonna use a pencil. So this is not a local brand, so I guess today is dedicated for local brands, Indonesian local brands. But I guess you can just find any brow pencil, like drugstore brow pencils. Just, you know, the one thing that is very important for applying eyebrow, drawing your eyebrow, is to draw like soft drops for softer eyebrow. Start in the middle. Draw the outer edge first. Too far. just grab your spoon. Okay, so I have this. This is actually the Anastasia Beverly Hills number 12 brush that I use with the pomade, but I'm just gonna use the spoolie with this one. Just brush it out to even out that. Back to this palette. Highlighting mine, so let me just take the light one here. And I'm gonna go back to this brush. So blend it. Voila! We are done for the eyebrow. Okay, next we move on to the eyeshadow. And today, well, I didn't want to feature, so I'm just. Okay, I'm gonna grab my favorite, that is Too Faced Chocolate Bar. First, I'm just gonna grab this, also kind of liner. Where is it? Small eyeshadow brush. Creasing brush, I believe. And I'm just gonna take this brown color. Okay, it's called Milk Chocolate. Just draw it on my crease to define my crease. I'm gonna grab my blending brush. This is from Sephora. Just blend it. And grab my smaller blending brush. This is from 80 Tools, Korean brand. And I like to take this called Marzipan, this color. And then just put it on the rest of my eye. Like that. And then grab this white chocolate. And then I'm gonna grab this champagne truffle to highlight the inner corner of my eye. So that, just a little. Alright, now let's go back to this one shader brush. And I like to use this black forest truffle. It's like a dark purple color. And then just apply it with the corner. And I got three corners here. And I'm gonna grab some creme brulee. Of my lower lash. Okay. And with the same brush, I'm just gonna take this triple fudge to line my eye. And grab your blending brush. Okay, so, well, the eyeshadow is done. Now we move on to our eyeliner. I'm just gonna be using the gel liner from Maybelline. This is in black. because I'm gonna be putting on some falsies, so yeah, I need them really thick. Liner, black. Just gonna grab my small mirror here. See the difference? Actually, you can always add a black eyeshadow. Apply it over your eyeliner like this so that it has longer stain power. So why not try? I've got this NYX Smokey. I'm gonna grab the black one with my small eye brush shadow. Grab the white one and just, you know, apply on top so that it has longer stain power. I've never actually drawn such a thick eyeliner in my life, on my eye. I'm gonna just curl my eyelids a little. Okay, and the lower lash too. If you have longer, lower lash will be easier for you. My lashes are not as long, so. I still have a little product over here, so I'm just gonna clean it up right away. Okay. And I'm gonna be using this, this is from a local brand, I think it's handmade from Ratubulumata. Basically translates as the Queen of the Falsies. This is base piece number 111. Just gonna try this. Okay. And grab my tweezer. Let's see if it will fit. I'm just gonna try the line first. See if it's okay. I think it's okay. So I don't need to trim it. If you find the lashes are a bit too long, then you can just trim it. Okay, well, I do have lash glue, but I like to use this Koji Eye Talk. It's actually for the double eyelid, but it can be also used as a falsies glue because the application is much faster. It comes with a little brush, and then I'll just like brush it. Just wait for a few seconds for it to dry. And then start applying. Try to apply it as close to your lash line as possible. Next, I'm gonna be applying some mascara on my lower lashes. It's from Silky Gear, called the Eye Opener. I like the brush that it comes with. It's actually exactly what I'm looking for my lower lash. And now, just to add a little bit drama for the lower lash, I'm gonna grab this BA1 from Tulipe. It's a lower lash, but because I'm going for a scissor. Okay, first ray. But you can always use the rest later. So don't worry. Okay. Grab it. It also comes with a clear bag. So set for the eyes. Let's move on to the lashes. I'm just gonna grab this NYX. This is Cooper's Gold. It's currently my favorite. I'll just grab my blush. Blusher brush. Get some product. Apply on the apple of my cheeks. Set, and then for a little bit of highlight, I'm gonna use this Pupa. I got it from Sasa Hong Kong. It says that it's from Italy, made in Italy, so it looks like this. This one is actually more clearer, well, this is matte. I'm gonna grab my blending brush just now. Where is it? Let's go for a blending brush. That's what I like to use to apply a little bit of highlight from my nose tip. I might keep it out. So that. Maybe add a little bit of the matte highlight on my nose bridge. And get the darker one here. I find it overlapping contour and highlight, cream contour and highlight with powder one. It's gonna help it make, you know, help it last longer. Okay. Last step will be, of course, the powder, RCMA no color powder. I'm gonna get the largest oval brush I have, which I use for powder. Just apply it with that. This will be the last step, of course, before the lips. Just tap off some excess. I love this powder. It's transparent and it really helps to, you know, fix my makeup. It helps it last longer. And then the last step before, of course, ColourPop and magic wand. I'm just gonna use a magic wand here. And I just keep boxes of cosmetics. So this is what it looks like. It's a new color. Top and to your lips. Well, this is basically the final look. Well, of course, before my hair gets up. I'll see you next time when I do have some free time to do more videos. Bye!